You believe that that an ideal government, an ideal state, an ideal nation should be led by these Islamic laws that are strictly applied, under which I am not allowed to speak, I should be put to death for my ideas, or homosexuals should be put to death, adulterers should be put to death, and all these things. Obviously, you don't agree that that liberalism is a good system, and you think that liberalism is a terrible, bad, immoral system. But I want to ask you, where do you live, Daniel?
I mean, I live in the U.S.
You live in the U.S. Why do you live in the U.S.? I mean, this is a question of consistency.
This system of liberalism is imposed on the entire globe, and that there is no country in the world today that actually implements the Sharia in the fullest meaning and sense of it. I wish that I could go to a country and that's ruled by Sharia that the West won't bomb and sanction and destroy. I wish I had that opportunity, but unfortunately I can't because of liberal supremacism.
Wouldn't it be more honest and more consistent with yourself, especially also to prove to others that you are trying to spread your ideas to move to a country, for example, that is ruled by Islam?
What country should I move to?
Any country that has...
Saudi Arabia, where they're imprisoning scholars for saying anything in line with the Sharia. If I were in
for
Saudi,
example, yes.
Right? Why are they doing that? Saudi is doing that because of who? The West, right? Because of Israel, right? Because of America, right?
You glorified Brunei, for example. You wrote an article that says, salute the Sultan. Logically, and I mean, anyone can see this, isn't Brunei much closer to your ideal world than America?
Well, I mean, there's other issues as well, like with me personally, because I was born in the U.S. These countries aren't giving me citizenship. They won't give me citizenship in many cases. And unfortunately, because of the nation state system, if you're not a citizen, you aren't born there, then you're a second class citizen.
Like, you want to talk about discrimination and you want to talk about two-tier status in Islamic law, look at the modern nation state and the two-tier status between citizens and non-citizens and the different treatment on the basis of where you're born. How is that more rational than the kind of treatment within Islamic law between on the basis of belief, like the believer, the Muslim versus the non-Muslim?
I feel like we're beating around the bush here.
No, that's exactly the reason. I have also personal reasons because my family is here. My family, my parents are here, they're elderly, like I can't just leave them. So if you want the complete honest answer, that's a big part of it. But if it weren't for, like, I mean, take it for what it's worth, but if it weren't for my parents being here, I would leave the United States. I'm just enjoying to live in America because I'm a secret hypocrite.